Hi everyone, welcome to the fourth session of chapter 3 force 8th standard physics. In the last session we studied about thrust and pressure. Thrust is the total normal force experienced by a surface and pressure is the thrust acting per unit area. So in this session we will focus on liquid pressure and atmospheric pressure. Do liquids exert pressure? Yes, they do. Liquids as well as fluids exert pressure. They exert pressure towards the base as well as the walls of the container in which it is enclosed. So towards the base they exert pressure downwards and the pressure on the walls is exerted towards sideways. Now let us define what is liquid pressure. The thrust acting per unit area by a liquid is liquid pressure. Liquid exert force on all sides of the container in which they are taken. So consider a beaker containing water and there are three holes in the side of the beaker. You can see that the water flows with a greater force and moves to a greater distance through the hole at the bottom. That is, pressure at the bottom is high. You just imagine that the beaker is divided into three equal parts. Then we can say that the second layer holds the weight of the first layer and the third layer holds the weight of second and first layer. As a result, the third layer exerts more pressure. So the pressure exerted by the third layer is high when compared to the first layer. So we can say that as the depth increases, liquid pressure also increases. As the depth decreases, liquid pressure decreases. The pressure exerted at any point in a liquid depends on height of the liquid column above that point. Now let us see what are the factors that influence the liquid pressure. So we have the formula P is equal to HdG. Here P stands for pressure and H is the height of the liquid column and D is the density of the liquid. Suppose you are provided with two PVC pipes of identical length and two identical balloons. Just fix the balloons at the bottom of the PVC pipes. Fill one with water and the other one with kerosene. You can see that the one which contains water expands more. The difference in the expansion of the balloon is due to the difference in the density of the liquids. Water is having higher density when compared to kerosene. So density is a factor that influences liquid pressure. So the third factor is acceleration due to gravity. So we can say that liquid pressure is directly proportional to weight of the liquid over unit area. Dams are constructed with greater thickness at the base. Give reason. The pressure at the bottom of the dam is greater than pressure at the top. So in order to withstand this high pressure at the bottom, dams are constructed with greater thickness at the base. So here, as the depth increases, liquid pressure also increases. Now let us move to the next topic, that is atmospheric pressure. We know that there is air all around us. This envelope of air that surrounds the Earth's surface is called atmosphere. The gravitational force of the Earth constantly pulls this atmosphere towards itself. As a result, this atmosphere exerts a pressure on the surface of the Earth as well as any object on the surface of the Earth. This pressure exerted by the atmospheric air is called atmospheric pressure. So let us see the definition for atmospheric pressure. The weight of the air column over unit area of the Earth's surface is called atmospheric pressure. We know that this atmosphere is extended up to many kilometers. The density of the air near the surface of the Earth is greater and it decreases as we go up. So we can say that atmospheric pressure decreases as we go up. The unit of atmospheric pressure is bar and the instrument used to measure atmospheric pressure is barometer. Now let us gain some idea regarding the magnitude of atmospheric pressure. So this is a rubber sucker. In order to fix this rubber sucker on a smooth surface, we will press it. On pressing, what happens? Most of the air between the surface and the sucker is removed. As a result, pressure inside decreases. The atmospheric pressure from outside acts on it and it is fixed on the surface. In order to pull the sucker from the surface, you have to provide a large amount of force to overcome the atmospheric pressure. And in fact, it is said that if there is no air at all between the surface and the circle, then it is not possible for a human being to pull it off from the surface. So, I hope you got an idea about the magnitude of atmospheric pressure, how large it is. So, have you ever thought why we are not crushed under this pressure? We are not experiencing any pressure on our body. Why? It is because the pressure inside our body balances the atmospheric pressure outside. In our daily life, where atmospheric pressure is used. So, first one is wringing juice using a straw, working of syringe, filling ink in fountain pen, taking medicine using dropper, fixing rubber suckers on polished surfaces. So, in all these examples, first of all, the air inside is removed by pressing or sucking. As a result, pressure decreases. Then the atmospheric pressure acts on it and the liquid enters into it. As mountaineers climb higher altitude, there is a possibility for nasal bleeding. Give reason. So, we have studied that as we go to higher altitude, atmospheric pressure decreases. But the pressure within our body remains same. So, there is a large difference in the pressure inside and outside. As a result, the minute blood vessels inside the nose, ears, etc. will break and causes bleeding. So, that's all my topic. Today, we studied about liquid pressure and atmospheric pressure.